on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, John Locke, Rose Matafeo, Harry Hill, Alex Horn in the Horn Section, Susie Dent, Rachel O'Reilly, and your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain Sean Locke. Many women find Sean Locke sexy and fantasize about getting him alone for some grandpa grumpy, rumpy pumpy. And joining Sean tonight, it's comedy legend Harry Hill. Harry has a unique look, like a testicle, off to play a game of golf. Up against him this evening, team captain John Richardson. John appeared on the TV show Comedians Watching Football with Friends, I assume, alone.
I watched it with my best mate, actually, Claire Sweeney, off of Brookside.
Do you still keep in touch?
I follow her on Twitter. My best mate. After you. And you. We're best mates, aren't we?
Yeah.
Oh. Just do a joke about me being small and let's move on.
Fun fact, John is short for a man, 5'2". Come on. And John's teammate, Rose Matafeo.
Yes.
Rose has a paralyzing fear of rodents with their furry little bodies and rat-like features, so we can only apologize for sitting here next to John. Harry, it's your first time on the show. Are you going to be better with the letters or with the numbers, Harry?
Oh, well, you know, I have this I have this problem with letters. I see a letter and I associate it with the smell. So, for instance, the letter, I don't know, A, I'd smell elderflower straight away. And then D, I might get morning dew. Straight away, I'm getting morning dew.
The letter F?
Wet wipes. So I'm worried about it. I'm going to be like a basset hound in a perfume factory.
Do you have any hidden talents?
Oh, well, I know where this is going. Who told him? Was it you?
No, I never said anything. I don't never talk to him.
It's the moonwalking, mate.
Can you moonwalk?
Well, I learnt from the master.
Michael Jackson?
Philip Schofield. You may not know this, but when Michael Jackson died, Philip Schofield bought all his shoes. Mainly flip-flops. And because his feet are a different size to Michael Jackson's, he had to trim them all. So often I would go round for my lesson, he'd be trimming these. And he only gets the afternoons because he works in the morning. So I do moonwalk, but I haven't come here to do it. I'm not doing it.
Come on, we want to see. Interested to know, Sean, if you've tried any interesting diets.
Yes, I have, Jimmy. I've found a whole new food source, and it's very exciting. And what I've got into eating recently, and it's a real delicacy, is fatbergs. You know, down the sewers, you get a fatberg. Yeah. And I know you're going, ugh, because everyone's told you, they're absolutely delicious. They're like truffles. And I go down the sewers and hunt out Batbergs. Obviously, I don't take a truffle pig. I take a rat on a lead. Honestly, Jimmy, they are delicious because you cut a slice like it's like a cake, and it's savoury one end, sweet the other, with a bit of hint of Dettol in the middle. What I do is I get a trained sushi chef to cut around the condoms and wet wipes. Just get the really, the really tasty bits. So that's what I'm into.
OK, now, Rose, you're from New Zealand. You now live in London. What's the worst thing about living in England?
The plugs are weird.
Why are our plugs weird?
Well, they're different to where I'm from. My plugs, they look... Mine one looks like, kind of like the Scream. It's like kind of like that. Ooh, it's sad. And your ones kind of look like you.
Yes, that's got a point. It's got a point, actually. Yeah, I can see it. Yeah, I can see it. Yeah, I can see it.
Oh, I see. I think. Yeah.
John, if you could bring one thing back from the past, what would it be?
What I would like to bring back is the airing cupboard. You don't really get an airing cupboard in a house anymore, do you? I don't know if it's because boilers have got smaller or people are renting them out in London. But I used to go in there and have my lunch. I'd hide there and try and scare people, play a bit of hide and seek, and then come out when no one fucking looked for me. It's like having a holiday home when you're six, having an airing cupboard. That was like, that was my jeet.
Why would you have given an airing cupboard a second thought? You're in the prime of your life.
Exactly. I'm still banging. I don't miss that. You don't miss what you got on tap, mate. Yeah. Do you?
It's because of, on a serious note, it's because of improved lagging on the immersion signal.
You don't get the warm air.
You don't get the warm air anymore.
What are we on a saga holiday now? How is this a conversation?
If you want to get back, you know, a way of getting back, if you're ever spurned by a lover, one of the ways to get back is, as you know, you start off with a kipper on the exhaust pipe. You know that one? So when she starts up the car, it stinks. next stage up would be to sew prawns into the hem of the curtains. Okay? So when that starts to decay, all right. Then the best one, if you can get a dolphin into the immersion heater. That really stinks.
Yeah.
She won't forget you then.
Rose, have you got a mascot?
I do have a mascot. I wanted to bring something that would relax me, and I'm quite a crafty person myself. So I have a stack of my favourite adult colouring in books, which is great. And I've got to say, an adult colouring in book, it's a fantastic gift to give to any loved ones when you want to kind of show that you're concerned but want to keep it fun. because these are for, you know, your mental well-being. But I really enjoyed doing them. So I actually started filling them out, but I'm kind of freaked out my family because I started doing them but purely in black Sharpie pen. So that kind of freaked them out a bit. That's a turtle there. That's some ducks and stuff. And then I just started writing stuff that I kind of went outside the lines a bit and started just writing stuff I wanted to get off my chest to my family. So I've got help me there. this one, my dad's girlfriend is a cat. So that's my mascot.
I like it. Yeah. I like it a lot. John, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, sort of. I get a lot of stick on this show for liking the maths, but I thought I'd find a way of making maths cool. And I know what people like, pop music. So I've written an equation, a mathematical equation, with music bands that we can solve. Hello, Rachel.
Hello.
How are you?
I've got this in my hand. Sorry.
Yes, this is all mine.
Great.
I don't like to share. So where would you start here, Rachel, if you were tidying up this equation? Sine A squared seasons times by O to joy plus U all over Duran equals Duran multiplied by tops brackets joy to the world all over B squared or minus U plus 1. You'd times by Duran, wouldn't you? That's what you do. You tie it, so you times by Duran. That's solving your problem on this side. And then on this side, of course, you'd have Duran squared or Duran-Duran. As they're more popularly known. Now, you look on this side, you've got sine. Now, I saw the sine and it opened up my eyes. So, of course, we can substitute there for Ace of Base. You haven't been studying, have you? Ace of Base. Now, Ace of Base, as we know, sang All That She Wants. Duran Duran, they sang All She Wants Is. So if we divide both sides by the thing that she wants, that would, of course, cancel those out. So let's get rid of that U. We can add U to that side, and that'll cancel that bit out. And, of course, here we'd have two U's, or U2. if you like, and you two, of course, sang that we can do this with or without you. So if we take the without you option, then that removes the you from that side as well. and then we can get rid of those brackets. Are we having fun yet, kids? It's cool to learn. Oh, I didn't expect to get out of breath writing on a board. So we could put the B squared there, B squared, A squared, seasons, tops and joy to the world. Now, if we divide by four, we know there are four seasons, so that cancels that one out, and, of course, four tops, so that one cancels that one out as well, and then we're left with joy to the world and ode to joy. So, of course, we need to remove the joys, or, if you like, carry out a joy division. from the equation, and here we're left with ode two, or minus two, if you will. So we take the minus two, add two to cancel it out, and you're left with three on this side. Three is, of course, a magic number. So if you rub the three hard enough there, it comes right off the board and you can just hold it in your hand like that. So that's a three. You can have that. Thank you very much. And then you're left with B squared, A squared, or BB, AA, or if you prefer, ABBA, who, of course, sang Money, 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 It's a Rich Man's World. And that leaves us back to you, Jimmy.
Yeah. Just wondering, trying to sort of date out for your intervention. Sean, have you got a mascot?
Now, what I've done, Jimmy, I've created something I call Total Comedy. I don't know if you're aware of the Dutch team of the 1970s, the famous Dutch football team of Johan Cruyff. They played Total Football. Created Total Comedy. I hope you're ready for it.
It's just a seventh hit.
Now, what it is, it's basically my comedy characters. I do a lot of great comedy characters. I'll just go through them, you know, some of them, like this one here. Put the cat out!
That's a good one.
That one's Rene. No fixed abode or gender. That's Darcy Wimbles. This is... Oh, you've done this place up nice.
Jed, that is enough.
That's Artful Archie. Oh, I have three of your warmest soups. This is Cheeky Lionel. No! You can't have any of mine! Now, the cheeky's ironic, because he's actually quite rude. Put that lid down! Never mind why. Put it down! Does anyone have a phone charger? That's Stephen from Belfast. Do a lot of corporate stuff with him. Not corporate stuff. And then I always finish with say, I think we all know who it is. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Because my singing teacher said, Sean, you have an amazing tool.
Sean Locke, Total Comedy. Harry, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I bought my son from my first marriage with me. Gary. Gary, come on out.
I don't want to come out there, I'm too scared. Everyone's staring at me.
It's Gary. It's Gary, my son.
Hello, everyone. Where's Jimmy Carr, Daddy? Where's Jimmy Carr?
He's a big fan of yours, Jimmy.
Christ, it's like looking in the mirror.
So,
I'm very nervous, Daddy. Can I do my song, Daddy?
You're going to do your song?
He wants to do his song. I want you to write a tribute to the soul singers of the past, Mr. Otis Redding, Daddy. OK, Gary, well, notice that we've got the horn section over there. Would you be able to cover this, Alex? Horn?
Yes, yes. What's the song?
He's sitting on a dog's day.
All right. OK.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting in the evening comes, watching the ships rolling, and I'll watch you roll away again. I'm sitting on the dock of the day, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the day, wasting time.
Off you go, Gary. Yeah, see you later. Nice one, Gary.
It's on topic.
Well, don't thank me, thank Gary.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Alex Horn in the horn section. Alex, what sort of music do you like listening to?
Well, abbreviated songs, Jimmy. When you stop them too early. You know, when you arrive at your destination, the radio stops early, but sometimes it improves the songs. That's the sort of song I like.
I need a couple of examples now. I'm not entirely clear.
OK, well, abbreviated songs. I'll do a song by Jarvis Cocker for you. OK.
Joe.
By Joe Cocker. OK, here we go.
You are...
OK. Sort of thing. I think he improves it. Can I do one by Robert Palmer for you, Jimmy?
Would sure. Right?
Okay, this is a song by Robert Palmer, the abbreviated version.
You know you can't get enough. You know you're gonna have to face it. You're a dick.
Okay, so it's again, it's the same sort of thing. Okay.
And with Alex, of course, it's Susie Dent. Great that Susie Dent is here, because while she's here with us, she's not writing another one of her shitty books. Susie?
Yes?
You've done a guide to swearing for all four. Tell us everything.
I was just writing down bollocks, in fact.
Shopping list for later, is it?
I love bollocks, because it's just useless.
Well, they fit in your eye socket.
And the reason I love it particularly is because the BBC do this kind of list of top offensive words. They do a kind of countdown. And bollocks is number 8, and it is... under prick and above arsehole.
What's number 6?
Wanker. This is a bit weird.
Well, I only asked.
Come on. And in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. We've got the horn section on. What's your favourite kind of music to dance to?
Well, Pasha takes me to salsa, and it's good because he can spin me around, but I actually taught him a dance. I'm quite proud of that he just didn't know, because he's already, you know, good with the ballroom, good with the Latin. But the good old-fashioned big fish, little fish cardboard box, he didn't know that till I came along.
That's dolphin in the immersion.
OK, tonight, the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Shopping Trolley. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Rose, you get the first pick of the letters.
Oh, shall I? OK, a vowel, please.
Thank you, Rose.
Oh. Consonant.
T.
Two vowels, please.
Whoa.
You... Yeah, I make it hard. It's fine.
I.
I stick some consonants up there.
Yeah, two consonants, please.
S. R.
Another consonant.
B.
Do you want another consonant or vowel?
One of each.
One of each, please.
An E and the last one.
Okay.
N.
Harry, what can you smell?
I've got shaving foam, Princess Anne, asparagus, jockstrap, pork, bacon, human remains.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Sausages for everyone. Anyone want a sausage? Oh, those are the meat ones. What's we got?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, I made burgers as well by the looks of things. That's vegan ones.
Oh, is it? Vegan, thank you.
Oh, I should probably ask. Harry, how many?
Six.
Six? Okay, Sean?
Yeah, those are sixes.
John, how many?
Well, an eight, but I think I've been influenced.
Okay, Rose, how many?
Six.
Okay, Harry, you're six?
Unrest.
Unrest, nice. Sean, you're six?
Brutes.
Brutes?
Yep.
Yeah.
Rose, you're six?
Strobe.
Strobe, okay. And John, for the points, you're eight.
Well, I was watching, so I got Bernie-est.
Bernie-est?
You were quite burnt, but it looked like Fabio was the Bernie-est of the two.
Is it in there? Is Bernie-est in there?
No, Bernie-est. Sorry, John.
Son of a gun.
Well, 6 points to both James. Alex, Susie, pretty much the dream team in Dictionary Corner. Now, what could they have had?
Well, there's bounties, is there? Bounties for eight.
Mm-hmm. So, at the end of that, it's 6 points to both James. On to our first numbers round, OK? Sean, Harry, you get a pick of the numbers.
Two large, four large ones, isn't it?
No, two. Two large and four small.
We've got
three.
Three.
A four.
Four.
A seven. An eight. I know all these. 75. I could do your job. Okay.
And the target, 847.
Ooh.
Okay. Alex, would you like to play the clock music?
Yes, we're going to do gong-based music, if that's all right. Heavily gong-based.
Sure, your time starts...
Absolutely not.
No, nowhere near.
863.
Okay, Harry, did you get it?
Yep.
Okay, Sean, did you get it?
No, I got 853.
John, did you get it?
I think so.
You think you got it? Well, Harry, how did you get it?
8 times 100 is 800, then 4 and 7, 847.
John, how did you do it?
I did 8 times 100.
Yep.
Add 75.
Yep.
And then subtract 7 times 4.
Well done.
Mm. I mean, two different methods.
This is quite a treat for me, because I'm vegan.
Look at this for a second. Look, it looks like John's a normal sized boy.
Oh, we're nearly going to put all that in, then.
John, are you going to try and put a whole burger in your mouth?
He'll double in size.
Down this it.
Okay. What do I get if I do it?
Indigestion. Don't try that at home, obviously. Oh, he's thought... Oh, no, no, no biting. No biting. The scores for the moment. John and Rose are on 16. Sean and Harry have 6. And here is your teaser. The words are horn lice. The clue is this should get rid of them. That's horn lice. This should get rid of them. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were horn lice. The clue was this should get rid of them. It was, of course, chlorine. So, John and Rose are in the lead. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Harry. So, Harry, your turn to choose.
The... letters. The letters.
Letters.
Yes.
Consonant, please.
G.
Shaving foam. Consonant.
L.
Jockstrap. Vowel.
A.
Which, of course, is...
Elderflower.
Elderflower, thank you. Vowel, please.
I.
Dettol. D. Can I have a D? Gladiator.
S.
T.
R.
E.
O.
And another... What do I want? Another vowel.
Yeah.
E.
Another consonant you want.
And an M.
OK, and your time starts now. Fed this bloody thing.
I like snakes. I was once peed on by a snake, though.
Yeah, I think you're a very naive woman.
Wow.
Rose, do you want to have a touch?
I guess so.
Yeah, it's Jesus. Pretty nice.
Nah, actually.
What do you mean?
That's just...
What?
It's quite heavy.
What do you mean it's quite heavy?
Yeah! No! Honestly.
Fuck off. Rachel. Don't put the snake near my face. We've been through this.
Hang on. That's not.
I think. Whoa, 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 whoa. That's. No, that's where I keep. Oh, he's found a soulmate. No, we're fine.
I bet I could get it all in my mouth.
Harry, what have you got?
Throw them on you.
6.
John, what have you got?
7.
What do we have to do? Sterilise? Why do we have to sterilise?
Oh, God.
TB?
It's a shame the snake didn't get to come out for the numbers because I hear they're great adders.
Hey! Don't do that to my friend!
Harry, you're 6?
Gamers.
Gamers. John?
I want to try girasol.
Girasol is definitely a word. It's a sunflower. Well done. It's amazing. Yeah.
A girasol is a spray on giraffe.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Rose have 23, Sean and Harry have 6. Alex, Susie, could they have done any better?
There's another 7. There's my dog's name, Oralism.
your dog's called?
Oralism! Oralism! And there's 2 9s, San Miguel, probably, and Glamorize. Glamorize.
Ah. Right, time now for Sean and Rose to go head-to-head. Rose, your turn to pick the numbers.
All right, thank you. I will have a biggie, please. One biggie and a small. And then a big and then something else. I don't really know.
You've got what do you want? One more. You can have one more. Three big or two big?
I'll go one small. Sorry. No, I only want two big.
Two big?
Two big, yeah.
Four small.
Yes, please. Thank you so much.
That was the worst I've ever seen that done.
Four. Two. Nine. Ten. 150.
Okay. Oh, your target is?
754.
And your time starts now. Rose, did you get it?
I didn't get... I got a number.
What did you get?
I'm not saying.
OK, Rose is playing this one very close to her chest. Sean, did you get it?
I got it, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us how you got it?
9 minus 2...
7.
..times 100 is 700.
Yep.
..plus 50 plus 4.
10 points to Sean.
No!
OK, so John and Rose have 23, Sean and Harry have 16.
Oh, God.
OK, well, it's time to go once again to Alex Horn and the horn section, but Alex Horn seems to be missing in action.
He's just slipping in something a little more sexy. So we've got a little sexy number for you.
OK.
Yeah.
Alex is going to be upset he missed that.
Yeah. I love Jamiroquai.
The scores at the moment, John and Rose have 23, Sean and Harry are on 16. And here is your teaser. The words are dire fart. The clue is it's really windy. That's dire fart. It's really windy. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were dire fart. The clue was, it's really windy. It was, of course, draftier. OK, on with the game. John, Rose, you're to choose the letters.
I reckon I could have choose a consonant, maybe, eh?
Yeah,
you're doing it.
T.
Yeah, I'm doing it. I'll do a vowel.
A.
And I'll do a little consonant.
R.
And please, another consonant.
F.
A vowel, please.
Oh, hello.
U.
Well, consonant, consonant, cons.
Ooh. M, G,
consonant.
S. I'd stick a vowel.
Vowel, please.
Okay, your time starts now. Harry, how many letters?
Smug.
Four, you mean? You mean four?
Four. Sorry, four.
You got a... you got a four-letter word?
Yeah, smug.
What... well, I'll come back to you and find out what your word is in a second. Sean?
I've got a six.
A six, OK. Rose?
No, fives.
Fives. John?
Six.
OK. Harry, what's your four?
Smug.
You're going to feel like a fool. There was a nine up there. Smug-o-far. Rose, your five?
Smart. Ironically.
John, your six?
Famous.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
Good one.
Sean, what was your word?
Mine is grouts.
6 points to both teams. Alex, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yes. There was my other dog's name, Orgasm. And Susie found a word, didn't you, Susie, for seven?
Ragus.
Ragus.
It's a posh version of what you get in the jar. Pay a bit extra, but you get an O and a T. Yes.
Get your rag out.
So at the end of that, John and Rose are in the lead with 29 points. OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Alex, what have you got for us?
Well, as you know, we like to collaborate with people like Drake and Dr. Alban, and we've been working a lot with... we've been working a lot with Henry Hoover, so we'd like to sing a couple of songs with Henry Hoover for you today, if that's all right. OK, so I'm going to edge round to... This is Henry. Henry's going to sing a first song, Jimmy, which is about bird watching. It's the difference between moorhens and coots. Here we go.
When the beak on the front of its head is bright red, that's a moorhen.
The second one is slightly more personal. It's a true story from Henry's backstory. OK, here we go.
I thought there was no one behind me as I walked down that road. I'd had a good look all around me. I was certain that I was alone. Oh, what a wonderful feeling, 'cause I'd needed to do it all day. And just then I heard someone snigger, so I had to hurry away. 'Cause I'd scratched my ass and then sniffed my finger. Yeah, he crushed his ass in a public place. I'd scratched my ass and then sniffed my finger. It's fine to do one or the other, but doing them both's a disgrace.
Thank you very much.
Alex Horn in the horn section. And here is your final teaser. The words are neat bonk. The clue is everyone loves these. That's neat bonk. Everyone loves these. See you after the break. The answer to the tease. The words were neat bonk. The clue was everyone loves these. It was, of course, banknote. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean, Harry, your turn to choose.
Consonant, please.
Ah.
Coconut. I'm dropping that now.
Vowel.
Another consonant, please.
K.
Another vowel, please.
A.
Vowel, please.
I.
I. Another consonant, please.
S.
S. Consonant, please.
C.
Consonant.
Yeah.
Consonant, please.
D.
D. And a vowel, please.
And the last one. E.
And your 30 seconds starts now.
That's good. I like that.
Thanks for lending us this, Susie.
What a one.
Harry, would you like a bite?
I'd love one.
Why not? Why wouldn't you?
Yeah. Well, see, I didn't get a sausage, and in many ways, a banana is a sort of vegetarian sausage, isn't it?
It's like owning a tortoise.
I want that. Where'd you get it from?
Seriously, Susie, how many speeds has it got? Sean, how many?
I'm afraid only six.
Only six, OK. Harry, how many?
Six.
John?
Seven.
Rose?
Seven. Creaked.
Creaked's good.
Oh, what about dickers?
Dickers?
Dickers, like double dickers.
Yes, it's to toy or fiddle.
Yeah.
No, dickers. Dickers.
Harry, you're six.
Kaiser.
Kaiser, is Kaiser a word?
Yeah, it is, but you can't have it as a verb, unfortunately, but it's good for six. Yeah? You can't Kaisered.
I didn't say Kaisered.
No, I know, it's good for six.
Susie, what? Feels to me, Susie, like you're throwing down, you're trying to cause trouble.
I don't have to come here, you know, I'm the voice of you being framed, for Christ's sake. Old lady falling over a wedding. Oh, dear, we can see her knickers. See you after the break.
He's still got it. He's still got it. They said he lost it. Sean, you're six?
Creeds.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is it in there if it's pronounced that aggressively?
Yeah, it's OK.
John, you're seven.
Creased.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Well, 7 points to John. Alex, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, John, how could he not have got Cardies?
Well, if I'm not wearing it, I can't say it. That's the rule.
At some point, I've got to put this banana down.
Down where?
It's going in. OK, so Sean and Harry have 22. John and Rose are in the lead with 36. OK, fingers on buzzers. Time for today's Countdown Conundrum.
You're going to make it spicy, Jimmy?
Am I going to make it spicy?
I meant, like, you know, maybe make the conundrum worth a bit more than it is humorous.
How much
make
you think
it a bit interesting, Mr. Bond.
You'd be the most amazing Bond villain of all time.
I'd be the only one who's skint. Comes out of a bookie and goes, no. Don't worry, we're still taking over the world. It's going to happen, it's just, you know.
Oh, I think the conundrum today is actually, it's quite a tricky one. It's actually worth 15 points.
Ooh.
Oh.
Because it's really hard.
Is the answer horseshit? Because the fucking rules are.
OK, fingers on buzzers. For 15 points today, let's make it interesting, the crucial Countdown Conundrum. Time starts now.
auditions.
Let's have a look.
Yes.
Oh, wow. So the final scores are... John and Harry have 22. John and Rose are our winners with 51 points. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Shopping Trolley. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
More next week, same time. Amy Schumer has a broken heart and tickets for a holiday. Time to bring Mom to South America for some kidnapping good fun in Snatched tomorrow at 10. But coming up, new naked attraction. Tell us what you like and pick a box. The date's in the bag on Channel 4.